Okay, so I have my paints ready. My daughter pointed out to me that I forgot to make orange. So in that case, what you can do is I did make some yellow and red, and I can mix my own orange by mixing them together. So if you have limited colors, that's a good option. All right, so now I have all my little colors of the rainbow here, and I have three different kinds of paper just to show you the difference. I realize that not everybody has watercolor paper. Obviously, that would be ideal. So I have watercolor paper, copy paper, and then just regular drawing paper. So just to show you the difference as to how it would look, it looks very much like traditional watercolor. You can manipulate it the same way, making it lighter by adding more water. You can blend it pretty easily. And it has a pretty good drying time, so not so fast that you can't go back into it and blend it really well, but fast enough that it's going to dry pretty quickly. So this is watercolor paper and what it would look like. On my copy paper, you see that the paint sits on the paper a little bit more and you can kind of manipulate it. Again, if this is all the paper you have at home, that's totally fine. And like I said, you can kind of blend the colors really, really well. And then here we've got our yellow, just kind of doing a rainbow. This is just drawing paper. It's a little bit thicker than the copy paper, so it'll allow for some little sturdier than the copy paper. But as you can see, the copy paper will work. This is the orange that I made from mixing my two colors because I didn't make an orange. And then this is going into the red. So as you can see, I can do nice blending, gives you nice rainbow colors. The colors are pretty bright, way brighter than I was expecting. So the one thing I did notice is that you can use it pretty much like watercolor. So if I wanted to use salt, just like I would make sure that there's enough color and enough wetness, enough water, and then I can simply put my salt on and that will give it texture. So that's a great way to, like I said, if you're doing water or something like that, or sand, add some texture. All right, so here I just laid out a quick drawing of a flower, sort of a sunflower. And this is me going in with the colors that I've mixed. You can see there's a light pencil drawing there. Just like with regular watercolor, if I wanted hard edges, I would need to let areas dry. If I don't mind the bleeding, I can paint it right next to it while it's still wet. You can see how it bleeds, which I think looks kind of nice. Giving a little bit more color. So it's very similar to regular watercolor. If I wanted to go in and paint around it, I could certainly do that. So it's very easy to use. It's an inexpensive way to create your own paints from old markers. And again, if you had limited markers, but you wanted to mix colors, you could blend them together after you've made the paint. And as a reminder, all you would need is red, yellow, and blue, and you can pretty much mix all of the colors of the rainbow.